Welcome to the E-Academy. Today I'm going to show you how the temperature detectors of the ABAX 2 system can be used with the Integra control panels to control the outputs. This in turn can be used when implementing building automation functions. In the previous episode, I added several ABAX 2 devices equipped with temperature detectors to the system. Among them was the ADD200 external dusk and temperature detector. Let's take a look at its settings. I'm going to load the DLoadX program. Control panel is already connected to the computer and the service mode is active. I open the Structure window, Hardware tab, Expansion Modular, Bus 1. I navigate to the ACU module settings. In the zone's outputs table, we can see that the ADD200 detector is registered at two zones. Zone 19 is responsible for the dusk detector. However, we are interested in the settings of the temperature detector, i.e. those at zone number 20. To begin with, it is necessary to define how such a detector is to work. You need to set the temperature value at which the detector will report a violation. It is also necessary to indicate how this temperature will be interpreted. It may be specified as a high or low threshold. What is the difference between the two? It is easiest to discuss it using an example. If we are monitoring the temperature and we want the system to inform us when the temperature rises above 20 degrees Celsius, we talk about the high threshold. It is marked with the letter H for high. How does it work? As long as the temperature measured by the detector is lower than 20 degrees, the system will not react. However, if the control panel receives information that the measured temperature exceeds 20 degrees, a violation will be reported. In the case of the low threshold, we are dealing with the opposite situation. Let's assume that we want the detector to react when the temperature reading drops below 10 degrees. So we set the limit temperature to that value, 10 degrees Celsius, and define the threshold as the low threshold. The low threshold is marked with a letter L as low. A violation will then be reported only when the temperature reading is below 10 degrees Celsius. We return to the detector settings. Three parameters can be set in the configuration field. The first one is the type of temperature threshold just discussed. The second parameter that we set for our detector is the threshold temperature. Here we can enter a value from the range of minus 30 to plus 70 degrees Celsius, with an accuracy of half a degree. The last, third parameter is tolerance. Here we can enter a value from the range of 0.5 to 10 degrees. What does it mean? This value indicates when the end of the violation will be reported. In the case of a low threshold, we add the value entered in the tolerance field to the threshold value. In the case of a high threshold, we subtract it from the threshold value. In this case, it is best to use an example like we did before. Suppose a low threshold and a value of 15 degrees Celsius is set. We set the tolerance to 2 degrees. The temperature measured by the detector is 20 degrees and starting to drop. When it falls below 15 degrees, the detector reports a violation. The temperature continues to drop to, say, 10 degrees. However, after a while, it starts to rise. So when is the end of violation reported? Here we have to take into account the program tolerance. We see that the temperature rises and exceeds 15 degrees, but the detector is still violated. The tolerance set at 2 degrees means that the end of the violation will occur when the temperature exceeds 17 degrees. 17 means 15, i.e. our threshold temperature, plus 2 degrees of tolerance. When does this apply? Well, for example, when we use temperature detectors, among other things, to control heating. And we want slight fluctuations of temperature not to cause frequent switching on and off of the controlled output. In order to achieve the best heating operation parameters adapted to individual needs, it is best to perform tests with several different threshold temperature and tolerance settings. Well, so let's check how it works in practice. On the keypad, we check what the temperature measured by the ADD200 detector is. This detector is located inside a room where it is quite warm. So we set the low threshold, a temperature of 15 degrees Celsius and a tolerance of 2 degrees. We write the data to the controller. Zone 20, to which the temperature detector is assigned, is set to response type number 47, i.e. no alarm action. I am now going to the list of outputs. I select output number 5. If you want it to be activated when the temperature falls below a preset threshold, you can select output number 24, mono switch with no cutoff time. So I set a time of 0 minutes, 0 seconds. We indicate zone number 20 as the trigger. We uncheck the timers. Finally, we have to check the option Active During Violation. Save the data to the control panel. The ADD200 detector was brought into a cooler place. On the keypad screen, we observe how the temperature readings sent by this detector change. To make the indication of interest more visible, I change the font size next to the other devices. Here is an important remark. Temperature indications on the keypad screen may change with a small delay of no more than a few seconds. To view the current temperature readings received by the controller from wireless devices, open the Wireless Devices list. As soon as the temperature drops below 15 degrees Celsius, output number 5 is activated. Okay, we see that the output has changed its state to active. It should be on all the time, until the temperature rises and the threshold value increased by the tolerance is exceeded. In our case, it will be 15 plus 2, so 17 degrees Celsius. Let's check. The detector has been brought back into the room. We see the temperature indication rising. As I said before, the output was turned off when the reading exceeded 17 degrees Celsius. Another important observation, information about the temperature is transmitted to the ABAX 2 system controller at regular intervals, i.e. during periodic communication. Therefore, when the temperature around the detector changes, this information may reach the controller with some delay. The time delay may be 12, 24, 36 seconds, or even 3 minutes when eco mode is set. The thermal inertia of the detector itself must also be taken into account. All this should be kept in mind when configuring the heating operation. We are returning to the DeloadX program. To control the output with a temperature detector, we can use an output type other than mono switch. This can be type number 109, zones logical and, if only one triggering zone is indicated at 109 output type, then this output will be active only when the marked zone is violated. If additionally other zones are marked, the controlled output will be activated only when all the triggering zones are violated. We talked more extensively about logical functions, i.e. logical and logical OR, in episode 47. What if we wanted the system to alert us when the program temperature is exceeded? For this, we can use zone type number 55, 24-hour high temperature, or zone type number 56, 24-hour low temperature. Now, for the sake of example, we will set type 55 to be told that the temperature has risen above the set point. We go to the controller settings and in the zone's outputs table, next to the temperature detector, we change the threshold to the high threshold. The temperature is set to 30 degrees Celsius. We write the data to the controller. We also save the data to the control panel. The service mode has been deactivated. The detector has been placed next to the heater. We can see the temperature rising. When the set threshold temperature is exceeded, an alarm is triggered. At the same time, output number 5 is activated. An appropriate notification is received on the smartphone on which the Integra control application connected with the system is installed. Now I can clear the alarm. I'd like to add that besides ADD200, the AXD200 wireless multipurpose detector is another device working within the ABAX 2 system that can act as a temperature detector. The AXD200 detector has one advantage over the ADD200 detector. We can program two thresholds. What can we use it for? For example, when the first temperature threshold is exceeded, the control panel can activate the chosen output, whereas when the second threshold is exceeded, the alarm can be triggered. We talked more extensively about the AXD200 detector in episode 61. One last comment. If the system based on the Integra control panel has temperature detectors, their settings can only be changed by the service team, so there is no possibility that the system administrator or other user could individually change, e.g. the heating control parameters. The situation is different in the case of Integra Plus control panels and thermostat-type outputs available in them. But I will tell you more about this type of outputs and their configuration in the next episode. That's all for now. Thank you, and feel invited to another meeting in eAcademy. See you soon.